Hello everyone, in this video we will see 8086 and the introduction to multiprogramming. Multiprogramming, before getting into that, we will see what is a process. A program under execution, it is called as a process. It is a programming unit performing the independent task. When we say multiprogramming, we will have two or more processes in memory, meaning two or more programs will be executing at the same time in memory. So it is executed in a time multiplex fashion, meaning even if there are two processes, only one process will be active at a time and it will be using the CPU, while the other may be performing IO operation or it may be blocked. The CPU executes only one instruction at a time. So multiprogramming, it is a time shared system, meaning each processes will get their time slices. Okay, so one process will be running and then it will be suspended and then the other process will be executing in the CPU. So if you see the process state diagram, a new process, first it will get ready. If it is getting the scheduling, meaning when it is ready to be executed in the CPU, it will change to the running state. And then if there is an interrupt, then it will go to the ready state, or if it is waiting for some IO resources, it will get into the waiting state. After it is completed, it might go to the terminated state. So we have something called as semaphores. So the reason to have semaphores is, so if you have multiple processes, they will share the hardware and software resources, and if only one process can have access to a shared resource, then that we call it as the critical section of code. So if there is a shared resource and if two processes simultaneously access them, then there might be a problem. So to avoid multiple processes to update simultaneously, we have something called as a mutual exclusion. So it prevents two or more processes from simultaneously entering the critical section. So the critical section, only one code can have mutual or exclusive access. So one way to achieve this mutual exclusion is flags. The flags used to reserve a shared resource, that is called as a semaphore. Then we have what is called as a common procedure sharing. So we will have library routines or system programs like IO drivers, code conversion routines, which might be used by multiple processes, and they will be common to all the processes. So they are called as a common procedures, which will be shared among all the processes. If we have the same process for different processes, then it will save the memory. So with code sharing, only one copy needs to be there in memory, so thereby saving the memory. So with respect to that procedures, we have something called as a re-entrant procedures. Suppose we assume process one is running and it calls a re-entrant procedures. So the procedure, it gets on, and if it is called back, the re-entrant procedure puts its intermediate result. So what will be the current result? It will be stored in certain area of stack. Now when the another process 2 is gaining control over to the CPU, the process 2 will also call the re-entrant procedure. So then what happens is, if the process 1 is rescheduled, then the process 1 needs to store its intermediate results in the shared memory, into the stack memory, so that it can resume from wherever it has left off when it is again put back into the schedule. So this is what is called as a re-entrant procedure. Then in the multiprogramming, system needs to have memory map table. So it will have allocated, meaning if the partition is currently allocated to a job, or it will have free table, map table, meaning if the partition is available for use by any of the processes, or unused if the entry is not associated with a partition. Then with respect to virtual memory, so this concept is used from processes like 80, 286 and above. So when we say the address, we have first is what is called as a logical address. Logical address is the address which is generated by the program instructions, whereas physical memory is the memory sent to the actual memory chip which is used in the hardware. So logical memory used by the program, physical memory is actually the hardware memory. The user can design a program in a logical space or virtual space without limitations of physical size. So what it means is, suppose if we have a program divided into several pieces with each mapped into real memory. So all the entire program need not be stored inside the memory, but and also these programs need not occupy contiguous memory locations. So only portion of program can be loaded into the memory for execution. So which means virtually more memory to work than exists. So whenever it is circuit, the other portion of the program will be loaded into the memory. So in 8086, we have what is called as segmentation. So each logical address contains a segment number and the offset similar to 8086. So if the 80286 follows the same procedure as 8086, then it is called as a real mode. The other one is called as a protected virtual address mode, which is available in the 80286. So real mode is same as 8086 when all the segment registers are used as in 8086. Whereas in the protected mode, the contents of the segment register are used to select segments, memory segments for virtual addressing. So 80286 will have one interrupt descriptor table, one global descriptor table, and unlimited number of local descriptor tables. So with this, what happens is there is a 48-bit extension register to hold the descriptors of current code, data, extra segment, and the stack segment. So the 24 address pins of 80286, they will be able to address 16 megabytes of memory. Whereas the logical address, if we see, 14 bytes of segment address. So in the segment register, it will have 16 bits, out of which 14 bits will be used for segment address, and the next 16 bit effective address will be used. So 14 plus 16 will have 30 bits, meaning it can use 2^30, which is 1 gigabyte of virtual memory. Even though the physical address is 16 megabytes of memory, the 80286 is capable of addressing 1 gigabyte of virtual memory. So with this, we'll see summarize what you have seen for multiprogramming. So we have seen what is multiprogramming, what are process, semaphores, and what are common procedures for sharing in multiprogramming, memory map table, and virtual memory.